Welcome back, Singaporeans. Very good to see you once again, especially residents of Punggol East. Mr. Desmond Lim has been answering a lot of your questions that you've been sending to singaporeelections@gmail.com. Your thoughts, your views, your feedback is important to us. We work as a party, as an alliance to serve the needs of Singaporeans. And today, Mr. Lim is going to be addressing a very important issue. It is of education. Every parent's dream is to make their child the best student, to have the best grades and pass exams with flying colors. But parents are writing in, the system of education is so stressed in Singapore. Parents are writing in, how can I make my child a balanced person? Not just focusing too much on academics, but also on all other aspects of life. And one of the letters that we got, something different, is focusing on the different budgets that are being allocated to different schools. Mr. Lim, you know this issue very well. We spoke about it just before we started shooting for this video. Please help us understand how and what proposals do you have for making the education system better in Singapore. Mr. Lim.
The government has made changes to the education system in Singapore. This has been done over the years to address the growing concerns of Singaporeans who have been rallying for a system that allows kids to be kids. Has this materialized? My question, in primary 3, children at the age of 9 are put through the GEP selections. The merits that were raised with this program was to allow for the distinction between the extraordinary from the ordinary. What has happened is children from more affluent homes have the resources to prepare for these exams, whereby giving them the extra edge over those who cannot afford it. Then do the end results really capture the gifted cup, or does it endorse those who can afford it? Where is the logic of this process? MOE has said being gifted cannot be trained. Is that really true? If I put two children with the same IQ in the same environments, one with access to all the classes and tutions, the other one with no extra help, who do you think will come out tops? Study the results of various educational centers. You will see many of the top students making that list. Then to add salt to the wound, these gifted ones get the best resources by being praised in the best schools. They are given a head start at P6 with DSA to enroll into the best SAP and private schools. The rest of the pack need the PSLE grades to get their foot in. Is this the equality our patch talks about? So, at the age of 9, we already brand our students. The decision not to announce top performance does little to change the mindsets of our parents. Is this a case of too little, too late? My solution, do away with the gifted programs. Give the P3s more time to develop before being streamed at P6. When they are older and more mature to decide what their priorities are, this gives late bloomers the time to catch up, and it gives all 12 years old an equal footing to bid for the best schools. No one should get a head start from 9 to these schools just because they sat for an exam at the age of 9.
Thank you, Mr. Lim. Your answers and your ideas on improving the education system in Singapore are remarkable. In fact, I think I could have benefited from them while I was also studying in school. Thank you for helping to make the lives of all Singaporean students and their parents better. Those of you watching at home or in your office, log on to your email access and write to us your feedback, your questions, your thoughts on how we can also make life in Singapore better. Email address is singaporeelections@gmail.com, and join us every day, every time, to listen to more ideas in making our lives better. This Saturday, remember to vote for Desmond Lim, dedicated local, determined leader to make our lives better, better and better. Thank you.